हेलो, गुड मॉर्निंग डियर स्टूडेंट्स। इन लास्ट वीडियो वी हैव सीन अबाउट द ऑपरेशनल एम्पलीफायर। लेट अस सी द रिव्यू ऑफ द लास्ट वीडियो एंड देन वी विल गो अहेड फॉर द नेक्स्ट पार्ट ऑफ द ऑपरेशनल एम्पलीफायर, पार्ट थ्री of the operational amplifier. Myself here, Lalit Kumar P. Bhaiya, Associate Professor, Bharati College of Engineering and Technology, Durg. This we have seen, definition of op-amp, operational amplifier symbol, and in terms of IC, we have seen this connections of dual power supply. We have seen this IC of op-amp, that is MU-A741, and its pin configuration, 8-pin IC. It is also available in 14-pin IC. This is the basic differential amplifier which we have seen, equivalent model of the operational amplifier. Differential amplifier we have seen to the plus VCC and minus VCC level. This is equivalent internal circuit of the operational amplifier is also we have seen. What is inside the operational amplifier, the circuitry, we have gone through this type of circuits also with respect to inputs, common emitter amplifier, and this is differential amplifier. Already we have seen this differential amplifier. Transistorized differential amplifier, there are different types, four configurations of differential amplifier, that is double input balance output, single input balance output, double input unbalance output, and single input unbalance output. These are the four configuration we have seen. This is the first circuit of the operational amplifier IC, differential amplifier with constant current source. And second stage is the additional gain stage, which is also a differential amplifier. These are the various stages of the operational amplifier IC MU-A741, which we have already seen. And this is total architecture of LM741 op-amp. Ideal op-amp, we have gone through this ideal op-amp. This is differential and common mode voltage. Differential is V1 minus V2. And common mode is average value of V1 plus V2. Characteristics of ideal op-amp we have gone. Infinite gain, common zero gain, common mode input signal, that is AC, infinite input impedances RI, zero output impedance ZO, and infinite bandwidth. These are the characteristics of the inverting and non-inverting amplifier which we have already seen, and this is equivalent circuit for the ideal op-amp. Ideal operational amplifier characteristics we have gone. This is the connection for the dual power supply, plus VCC and minus VEE, and we have also seen the virtual ground concept of the operational amplifier. This is virtual ground concept we have seen. Negative feedback, that is also seen. Feedback resistance RF is connected to the inverting terminal, and input resistance from the inverting terminal is grounded. That provides the negative feedback, that also seen. And standard circuit analysis we have also gone. This is the inverting amplifier where the input is applied to the inverting terminal and non-inverting is grounded. R2 is the feedback resistance, R1 is the input resistance connected externally. And RL also, load resistance. This is the virtual ground concept. This point we have seen. This is the virtual ground point. Since this terminal is grounded, non-inverting terminal, this terminal is called as a virtual ground. So no current flows through the amplifier, op-amp. So therefore, this input current flows through the feedback also. And we have calculated the gain of the inverting amplifier. What is slew rate? We have seen that is rate of change of output voltage with respect to time. To calculate this slew rate, we must connect the capacitor at the output and inverting terminal connected with this feedback resistor R1, and R2 is grounded and non-inverting input is given to the non-inverting terminal. This table we have seen the comparison between the ideal and practical op-amps, the various parameters, bias current, input resistance, output resistance, differential gain and current saturation. Open loop configuration we have seen, dual power supply and open loop configuration. This is the for open loop configuration, differential gain is greater than 10,000. Driven into saturation, in open loop always output is always into saturation, that is either plus Vsat or minus Vsat, and saturation level is nearly equal to the supply voltage. This is the closed loop configuration, closed loop configuration of inverting circuit. This is the inverting RF, this is RA, input resistance, input is given to this inverting terminal and this is output, and this is the internal equivalent circuit where it shows the input impedance and output impedance and voltage source A into V in. A is the open loop gain. This is equivalent circuit. RS is the source resistance here connected with this source RF, and three things to be considered: closed loop voltage gain for the inverting, input impedance and output impedance. Let us calculate the closed loop gain for the inverting amplifier. You have to write the KCL at the virtual terminal. So this is V in minus V output upon V in minus this V virtual upon RA plus minus V virtual upon R in V naught minus V virtual upon RF is equal to 0. You can see, you can write this equation by observing this diagram. This V in minus this voltage at this point upon RA, this voltage minus this voltage upon RF, you can calculate the values. So simply V naught, you go by using the open loop gain, you can calculate these values. V in upon RA plus V naught upon A into RA, A is the open loop gain, and you can calculate these values. So finally, closed loop gain you will get here, AV is equal to minus RF upon R1 or RA. RA is the input resistance connected to the inverting terminal and RF is the feedback resistance. So this is called as open loop gain of the inverting amplifier. Always remember, closed loop gain of the inverting amplifier, AV or AVF is equal to minus RF by R1, where R1 is the input resistance. Here it is written RA. So closed loop gain for inverting amplifier is always minus RF by Rin, RF by R1, you can say. The closed loop gain now reduced to the same form as an ideal case. Input impedance, if you look the input impedance at the input terminals, then total input impedance is given by Rin is equal to RA, that is R1, you can say, connected to the inverting terminal in series with the this R input parallel to R dash. So total input resistance you can calculate here. This R pi written here is nothing but the R in, equivalent R in of the input, equivalent R input of the operational amplifier. And R dash is the output resistance. So this can be calculated, input impedance. And finally, this input impedance comes to be R in is approximately equal to R A are in some circuits, RA in place of RA, R1 is written. So again, you can calculate R in is approximately equal to RA or R1 supposed to be. And actual value of R in is in terms of this equation. R in is equal to RA. RA means the resistance connected at the inverting terminal in series with this R input of the op amp, RF plus RO feedback resistance plus output resistance upon RF plus RO plus 1 plus A into R in. This R pi means R in, equivalent R in of the op amp, and A is the open loop gain. So you can calculate input impedance from this diagram. Note here, the op amp can provide an impedance isolated from input to output. Then output impedance RO. For output impedance, you have to calculate output voltage upon output current, V0 upon I0. So simply from this equivalent diagram, this is the equivalent diagram shown here, you can calculate R0 is equal to V0 upon I0. And this is the equation given for output resistance. R out is equal to R0 into in bracket RA plus RF upon A into RA is the output resistance. Then about bias current. All op amps draw a small constant DC bias current at their inputs. At the input, a small amount of bias currents are there at inverting and non-inverting both terminals. Typical value of IC741 is around 100 nanoampere. For IC741, this bias current is about 100 nanoampere. It is very less. And therefore, at virtual ground effect, we will neglect this current into the operational amplifier. This is only notable when very high impedance sources are used. In such cases, an alternative op amp with lower bias current should be used. If it occurs a spikes or current increases, then we can use the different operational amplifier. Bias current is separate to input impedance. It is equivalent to current source in parallel with the input impedance. Then offset voltage, these are the parameters of the operational amplifier. When both input voltages are equal, the output should be zero. Actually, it probably won't be due to an offset voltage between the inputs. Typically, this is around 2 millivolt. So try to understand what is the offset voltage. It is the voltage available at the input terminal when the output is equal to zero. How to make the output exactly the output equal to zero, whatever the input available will be the offset voltage. So offset voltage is the voltage applied to the input terminal when or to make the error in the output equal to zero. Error means output voltage available if both the inputs are grounded. That time output may be available, called as the output offset voltage. And this output offset voltage can be reduced by applying the input voltage. This input voltage is called as the input offset voltage. And typically its value is around 2 millivolt. This is not much, but is magnified so much by the op amp gain that it will probably saturate. So this voltage is very less, but if the amplifier amplifies, so amplifier goes into saturation. So output will be diverted to only plus Vsat or minus Vsat. Therefore, it is important to remove this offset voltage. Offset voltage is automatically compensated by negative feedback network. If we use this negative feedback along with this op amp, then this offset voltages will be reduced automatically. Can be a problem for precision comparator applications. In comparator, it is very must to reduce this offset voltage equal to zero. Otherwise, it will create the problem for the saturation levels. Saturation, I have already told you, V out cannot exceed the supply voltages. If the amplifier supply voltage is plus 15 volt and minus 15 volt, then saturation will be near about 14.5 to 14.8 volt, plus 14.5 or minus 14.5 volts. In fact, typically Vout can only get to within about 1.5 of the supplies. That means if the supply is 15 volt, then it may be up to less 1.5 volt supply. You can see this is the saturation level of the output. If this input peak is this one is the input peak, then this is the saturation level of the output. This is a near about plus VCC and this is minus VCC. 1.5 volt range may be there in this output voltage. Consequences of saturation. Unwanted. It is unwanted when linear amplification was required. Wanted when a clipping effect is required, that is distortion effect, popular with guitarists. So we need to avoid, sometimes we need to avoid this saturation levels in where we need a linear amplification, but it sometimes required for the clipping circuits also to remove the distortions. Essential when the op-amp is used as comparator. Input offset voltage is the small voltage needed to be applied between inverting and non-inverting terminals to get zero output voltage. I have already told you. Ideally, it should be 0 volt, but you will get in terms of microvolts. Common mode operation. And output voltage, output offset voltage, under the common mode operation, output voltage should be 0. But due to mismatch is devices, it is non-zero. Can be corrected by applying voltage between pin number 1 and 5. So already for 8 pin IC 741, pin number 1 and pin number 5 is given. This pin number 1 and pin number 5 is for null offsetting. So to remove this output offset voltage, we must use pin number 1 and pin number 5 with a variable resistance and connect it to the supply, so that we can reduce this output offset voltage. Input offset voltage, the ideal op-amp produces 0 volt out of for 0 volts input. Practical op-amp produces a small DC voltage at the output. This small DC voltage at the output is called as the output offset voltage when the input is 0. And input offset voltage is the voltage to remove this output offset voltage. Input offset voltage drift specifies how much the input offset voltage changes with each degree change in temperature. Input impedance between inverting and non-inverting terminal that we have seen. The open loop voltage gain, without applying any feedback, the open loop voltage gain is there. And for IC 741, it is around 2 into 10 to the power 5. Frequency response. By connecting capacitor at the output terminal, we can observe the frequency response. And frequency response is nothing but the gain in the magnitude of the gain in dB versus frequency, or the magnitude of the gain without unit versus frequency, and phase angle between output and input versus frequency. This frequency response can be obtained for the operational amplifier. And this is negative feedback. We also seen this one. Negative, for negative feedback, we connect the resistance in the inverting terminal and output, that will provide the negative feedback. So this negative feedback is one of the most useful concept in electronic circuits, particularly in amplifiers as well as in this operational amplifiers, because negative feedback having a lot of advantages. That will stabilize the gain, increase the bandwidth, increases the input impedance and decreases the output. These are the effects of the negative feedback. So this is important. An amplifier cannot give an output that has a voltage greater than its supply voltage. If the gain of the op-amp is 20,000, the supply is 12 volt and the input voltage is 2 volt, then the output is calculated 20,000 into 240. This is not possible. 40,000 is not possible. So our amplifier will saturate and provide around the 12 volt. Therefore, negative feedback is required to reduce this gain. That will increase the bandwidth also. This is non-inverting amplifier, where we connect the input to the non-inverting terminal. This input is connected to the non-inverting terminal. This is feedback resistance and this is the resistance to the inverting terminal and ground. So this is non-inverting amplifier where we apply the input to the non-inverting terminal. Non-inverting amplifier, I have already told you. This, if input is applied to the non-inverting terminal, output is also of the similar type. What is the gain of the non-inverting amplifier? The gain of the non-inverting amplifier is this 1 plus RF by R1. This gain is 1 plus RF by R1. Because it is non-inverting, so sign will be positive. And V0 upon Vin is equal to 1 plus RF by R1 is the gain. If for inverting amplifier, the gain is minus RF by R1. And here the gain is 1 plus RF by R1. This gain is calculated here. And the negative feedback has this gain V out upon V in is equal to A upon 1 plus A beta, where A is the open loop gain and beta is the feedback factor. So this can be calculated for the negative feedback. And calculating the gain with feedback for non-inverting amplifier, you can see here, this gain is given, calculated here, V out upon V in is equal to 1 by beta, and this value comes to be 1 plus RF by R1. RF is the feedback resistance, R1 is the input resistance. So this is always fixed for the non-inverting amplifier here. The closed loop gain V naught upon V in is equal to 1 plus RF by R1. The above formula gives the gain of a non-inverting amplifier. The non-inverting amplifier configuration, this circuit input is applied to the non-inverting terminal and inverting terminal is connected through the resistance R2 and R1 or RF and R1. Non-inverting amplifier voltage gain 1 plus RF by R1 or 1 plus R2 by R1, it is written here. This is the example for the non-inverting amplifier. Determine the output voltage and current for the given non-inverting amplifier. Here R1, RF are given and the voltage, supply voltage, input voltage is given 0.1 volt. Using the formula 1 plus R2 by R1, you can calculate the AV and output is equal to AV into VS. That is 1.53 volt here. And you can calculate the I0, V0 upon R2 plus R1, 33.3 microampere. This is inverting amplifier configuration that seen already. Here positive terminal is grounded and feedback is provided through this R2 or RF. And this is the non-inverting amplifier. Voltage follower circuit is shown here. And less than unity gain we have connected this amplifier. This is already said, minus R2 by R1 or minus RF by R1. And here at inverting point there is a virtual ground. Input and output resistances. So dear student, today we will stop here. And again we will see the another video tomorrow. By or using this operational amplifier. So one more lecture is required for the operational amplifier. Thank you very much for listening this video. Thanks to all.